Good morning. I'm so glad that you're here to worship with us today. Today we are celebrating our Christmas worship, and for that reason, we actually have our children's ministry worshiping here with us as well. And I think our kids may have prepared just a celebration of Jesus with some songs. And so I want to invite our children's ministry to come up and bless us.
Sent his son, he's the savior of the world, and now we can call him friend. God sent his son, he's the savior of the world, and now we can call him friend. Jesus Savior, Jesus Savior. Son, he's the savior of the world, and now we can call him friend. God sent his son, he's the savior of the world, and now we can call him friend. Jesus Savior, Jesus Savior.
Savior of the world. for Ping Pong on YouTube. Ping Pong.
Thank you.
So nice to be able to see how God is moving and working in our children's ministry, and to just to see them, although can't really see them because of their masks, and that was kind of a little funny. But I mean, you know, you can tell that they're worshiping and they're really bringing glory to the Lord with their song and with their hearts and their attitudes. And so we really do praise the Lord for that. We're in this time of just Advent, right? Preparation and thinking about what it means for us to be waiting on the Lord. This is the Christmas season, and there, if you go on like YouTube or on Netflix, there's like Christmas movies all over the place. I think that's like one of the new, I think it's kind of new, right? Where they started to make like all of these Christmas movies, like Christmas Prince and Christmas Marriage, Christmas Winter. I don't even know. Like there are all these Christmas movies made from, I think it's made from Hallmark, and they seem to, my family loves them. I'm not really into them, but I'm more like, the Christmas movie that I really enjoy watching is The Elf. There's this one scene in particular that I like that I want to share with you today. Let's watch this together.
Wow! What's this?
This is the North Pole.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Yes, it is.
No, it's not. Where's the snow?
Why are you smiling?
I just like to smile. Smiling's my favorite.
Make work your favorite. That's your favorite, okay?
Okay.
Work is your new favorite.
Fine.
It's time for the announcement. Okay. Okay, people, tomorrow morning, 10 a.m., Santa's coming to town.
Santa! Oh, my God! Santa here? I know him. I know him.
He'll be here to take pictures with all the children.
Yeah.
Just keep your receipts. 10 a.m. tomorrow.
10 a.m. tomorrow.
Santa's coming to town.
Yes.
Can you sign this for me?
Oh, hi. Santa's coming.
So, Buddy the Elf is so excited because Santa's coming. And he can't contain it. There's just like this so much joy. He's like, Santa, I can't wait. There's like this anticipation of Santa's arrival. Now, you know, when the manager makes this grand announcement, it's time for the announcement. He says, okay, 10 a.m. tomorrow, Santa's coming. And everybody else is like, okay, whatever. But Buddy is ridiculously excited, like overflowing with joy and overflowing with excitement. You know why? He says it. I know him. I know him. Like everybody else is like, okay, yeah, Santa, big deal. Like I know about Santa. We've heard about him. You know, we hear these stories about how he gives gifts to all these kids and all of that. But Buddy says, I know him. It's not just I've heard about him. You know, there's a legend about how he comes down chimneys and gives gifts. No, for Buddy, it's a personal, I know him. There is this joy that cannot be replicated by anyone else. I mean, even with children, like, you know, yeah, kids are excited, but sometimes you see pictures of kids sitting on Santa's lap and they're like terrified. Why? Because Santa's a stranger to them. I mean, they have this idea of who he is, but they don't actually know him. Buddy the Elf knows him. Santa! I know him! As we celebrate Christmas this morning, I want to ask you, do you have that sort of joy in your heart? Is there that same sort of joy like, oh, Jesus is coming! Jesus, I know him! And Jesus, I have this personal relationship with him that makes everything different. I know him. Or do we just go about Christmas and preparing for the new year the same way that everyone else does? Same way of shopping and trying to find good deals, having to buy gifts and make Christmas cards. Is that our Christmas? In Psalm 130, Psalmist writes, "My soul waits for the Lord. More than watchmen for the morning. More than watchmen for the morning. My soul waits for the Lord." You know what he's saying? He's saying there are watchmen on the tower who look out to make sure that the city is safe, and they stand there all night. They work and they labor all night. And they sit there looking at the horizon, just waiting for the sun to rise. They sit there waiting for the sun to rise. They don't have watches at that point, right? So they don't know exactly what time it is. Oh, only a few more hours. No, they sit there, and when you sit in silence, when you're by yourself, those minutes go by so slowly. But then, from the distance, peeks out just a little bit of light. And suddenly you realize what time it is. Just, I mean, in complete, utter, still darkness, a light begins to shine from the horizon, and you realize it's time. Oh. Safe passage through the night. There was no invaders that came. So, whew. But also, I could rest. The night is over. The work is done. And now I can rest. So more than watchmen wait for the morning, my soul waits for the Lord. There are a couple of stories that I want us to think about today. You know, Christmas stories. The first is about the shepherds. In Luke chapter 2, we get the story of the shepherds who were out in the field tending flock. And it says, "And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified." But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people." He says, "I'm bringing you good news that's going to cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger." He says, "Look, I'm bringing to you this great news, this news that's going to cause great joy. I'm bringing to you that word good news is the exact same word as the word gospel. I'm bringing to you the gospel that's going to cause great joy for all the people." Now, when we hear that news, when we hear this story, we often hear it as it being proclaimed, why did Jesus go to the shepherds of all people? Why would the angels go to pronounce and proclaim the arrival of Jesus to shepherds? And it's often preached because at that time, shepherds were considered probably working at night, tending most likely someone else's flock, low in societal structure. And so the angels came to share and proclaim the good news to the humble. And that's great news. But then as I was doing some research, I came to Steps of Faith, Jesus.com, and it gave this other explanation. I really like this. It says, the Mishnah is a group of documents that recorded oral traditions that governed the Jewish people during the time of the Pharisees. One of its regulations states, it expressly forbids the keeping of flocks throughout the land of Israel except in the wilderness. And the only flocks otherwise kept would be those for the temple services. Now, this is really interesting, because what it's saying is this. The flock that was being tended, the flock that these shepherds were caring for, were not just any flock. But these were sheep that were being cared for the purpose of sacrifice. And those who were caring for them then were Levites. They were priests. They were shepherds, yes. But they were in the service of the temple, priests, who were tending flock who would otherwise be sacrificed. This was their job, watching over this sheep that would be sacrificed. And so when the angels proclaim the Messiah has come, what he's saying is, you who have prepared the Passover lamb all these years, know that your time for rest has come. Know that all of the sacrificial system of the Old Testament is coming to an end. The age of sacrifices of the Passover lamb is ending. And so this great news for these shepherds are that their job is completed. All the hard work that they have done is completed. The labor and toil is done. And the reason that's good news for us is that it marks for us that same reality. That up to this point, humanity labored and toiled. We're bound by the law, trying to be good enough. Making every effort to earn salvation and to find favor with God. But never quite able to do so. Up to this point in history, all of their hard work, all of their labor, all their efforts of trying to be good enough was in vain. But now, Jesus Christ comes. He says, look, your time of trying, your time of labor is coming to an end. Jesus Christ comes and he says, the sacrifice of the Lamb is no longer necessary because of the true Lamb of God who will lay down his life for all people. So great joy for all people. Today we are talking about the arrival of joy. But I want to ask you this morning, is that where your heart is? Do you feel the joy of your salvation? Do you feel the joy of Jesus Christ who has come? You feel the stress, anxiety, and fear of the day. Brothers and sisters, yes, I know. We've labored and we've toiled. You know, in some ways, it's because there was no other choice. We had no other hope. We had no other options because we were given this law and we were doing our best to live according to it, but we continued to fail and we continued to not quite measure up. And because of that, we just continued to try and fail and try and fail and try and fail again. It weighs heavily on our person's heart to do so. It weighs heavily on a person's heart to know that we are just not quite able to save ourselves. But in that moment of darkness, peeking out from the horizon, the sun rises and tells us, I bring good news. This news is going to cause great joy amongst all the people. He tells us that our labor is done. This is from the parable of the talents. You remember the parable of the talents? Master gives his servants talents to go and do the work. He gives them these talents, these resources, so that they may bring back a profit to him. And now, after a long time, the master of those servants came and settled accounts with them. And he who had received the 5 talents came forward, bringing 5 talents more, saying, Master, you delivered to me 5 talents. Here, I have made 5 talents more. He says, Master, with what you gave me, God, I worked and I labored and I produced 5 more talents. And there will be a time when Jesus says this to us. The master said to him, Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful over the little, and I will set you over much. Enter into the joy of your master. There's this incredible promise that's given, right? When Jesus returns, when he comes in his second coming, the true labor will all end, and finally, God's great reward will be given. And that great reward is for us to stand before our God and our King to hear, Well done. Good and faithful servant. Well done. I wonder how much that matters to you. Sometimes I admit, even though, like for me, this is my driving force in life. Like for me, this is like the motivation above all other motivations. Like for me to know that one day I'm going to stand before God and hear, well done. Like, that's what gets me up in the morning. And yet, the truth is, sometimes it doesn't even come to mind. I think that's so sad. Right, if there is a single mantra for my life, it's this, right? To hear, well done, good and faithful servant. And yet, sometimes I get so overwhelmed by so many meaningless things that it doesn't even occur to me to think about this. And when that happens, I'll tell you what, joy feels so far away. There are moments when you go about our lives and kind of feel lost. Moments when we go about our lives and we just kind of, maybe it's the routine of things. Maybe it's the fact that, you know, we just, you know, one day kind of looks like the next. Until we finally get to the weekend and we can come and worship on Sundays and we celebrate that. But then again, there's Monday following again. So 1 week looks like the following week. Each month looks like the preceding month. Every year looks like the previous year. Now we're getting into decades. And sometimes people don't change for an entire decade. Sometimes we just go about our days without ever giving thought to what's my motivation? without ever giving thought to what's driving me. What is it that, why is it that I'm getting, going to work? Why is it that I'm caring for my kids? Why is it that I'm loving on my wife? Why is it that I get up in the morning? Sometimes we just go about our lives and an entire lifetime passes. We haven't changed. We haven't grown. Nothing has happened, and we don't experience joy because there's no real motivation. But the Lord tells us, at the end, we'll stand before God. Our master will return. And we'll hear it. Hopefully we'll hear it. Well done. Well done. But sometimes we get lost. In Matthew chapter 2, this is the other story, the Christmas story that we often hear about. It's the story of the wise men. The wise men that came from the east following a star. And when they approached Jerusalem, they went to Herod's palace in search of the king. And Herod was like, hey, he's not here, but when you find out where he is, you let us know so that we can worship him also. It's deceit. It's a lie. They were lost, right? These wise men had traveled following the star until they got to Jerusalem and they saw the palace and said, oh, I know where to go now. So rather than following the star that was leading them, they decided to start following their own wisdom. They decided to start following their own understanding, and it got them lost. But when they left the palace, they saw the star again. They were lost until they saw the star again. And then they rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. They rejoiced exceedingly with great joy. You know why? Because they were lost. But now, they found their way. In the story of Zacchaeus, Jesus says something similar to that. For the Son of Man came to seek and to save the lost. If you're lost and Jesus Christ comes to seek and save you, the result is exceedingly great joy. I mean, think about it. If you are completely lost, you don't know where you're going, you're trying to get to your destination, but you just don't know how to get there. And suddenly someone comes and says, here, I'll show you the way. How happy are you? How much joy do you feel? Sometimes it depends on the destination, right? Oh, I was lost and I was trying to go to McDonald's. I couldn't find my way. Oh, there it is. I found it. Okay, good. I'm glad I made it there. But if you're really lost and you're trying to get home, right, you've been wandering for days, maybe for weeks, and finally you get there, for maybe for months or for years or even a decade, and finally you find your way home. You find your way to your Father who loves you. How much joy are you feeling at that moment? Exceedingly great joy, because Jesus came to seek and save the lost. Each one of us, at some point, was that lost person. Each one of us, at some point, could not find our way, but Jesus came to seek and to save us. And for that reason, great joy. Some of us are still lost, to be honest. We're still following our own wisdom, following our own understanding, trying to figure it out on our own. I mean, the star is shining. When we see the star, will we follow it? Or will we just continue to go down our own path? We'll say, yeah, I'll figure it out. I know how to get there. Or will we just continue to be lost? The star is shining. When we look upon the star, you feel great joy. Jesus has come to seek and to save the lost. Great joy, exceedingly great joy. Let's pray together.